I strongly believe in our youth and our community, and I'm glad to see that our youth are taking initiative and being the front runners of the art scene. I think our youth, they have the talent. I've seen it before because as I got to grow up and talk with our youth, I've seen the talent. Like, we have wicked artists, guitar players, drummers, singers, and I think that if we keep showcasing our youth and let our youth know that they can be successful, then the better it is for them.
I'm here with John Sharphead. He is the lead guitar player of the band Global Genocide. It's pretty heavy stuff. How long have you guys been together?
We've been playing for 6 months of practice, and it's pretty much our first gig right now, so 6 months of practice is what we're doing.
How are you feeling about the gig today?
Pretty nervous because we're playing in front of lots of people for the first time, but at the same time, pretty confident because we're good. Really awesome to like that I'm doing something for the community and that I'm making something of myself. It's a really awesome feeling to be a part of this whole program.
I'm very excited for today. Just the energy out there, once we get out there and the performance starts, I think it's going to be a good show. Well, you know, Josh, that this started because of you. And, you know, honoring our youth that have excelled both nationally and internationally, I think is really important.
Lovely Savannah Yelany, one of the performers in the showcase today. Savannah, how do you feel about this event?
I'm really excited. I'm also like really nervous. I have never done this before.
When you first joined the program, you were really shy. And what has the program done for you in your life?
It really helped me to like open up because I don't know, just met like some really amazing people in the program that helped me a lot. I think it's awesome. And so
we have to give everything we can to promote their abilities. I mean, everybody knows everybody has a special ability, and we just had to create this program to let them be who they are.
Are you excited about this event today?
Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so proud. I don't know if I'm going to be able to hold it together because these kids are our kids, so.
Great. You know all the kids pretty much personally, all the ones that went to Kataskano. Being in the arts, how have they improved?
Oh, they have more self-esteem. They are more confident. They're out of their shell. They're just more energized. This is tragic. You couldn't
keep your hands to yourself. Well, to be honest, there's so much things that are happening in Enoch. It's good for kids who aren't into the violence or into that to escape from all that and show themselves what they're made of, and
So basically the response I've been getting from a lot of people is that we do need a native arts scene. We do need to put us on the map. How does it feel being a part of this scene?
Amazing. Feel one of a kind. I'm glad that this has happened. I've been totally into the arts my whole life. And for this to happen, it shows that actually people care. Under the clouds, oh, I was singing along to my six-string song. Before I go away so far. There is a spark. We just gotta find the flare for to be recognized. This is one of our only chances for the flint to light the fire.
How the art program had impact on my life is pretty good. I'm not shy anymore. I'm more confident. I'm proud to be Native. And
how does it feel being a part of the Native art scene out in Enoch?
I love it. It's awesome.
Enoch Student Services Manager. Cheryl, what do you think about the event?
I think it's absolutely fabulous. It's just one of a kind, first time. I think it's going to be great. I think it's very important. It's something that, you know, we've held on to traditionally with our regalia and our dancing. I think we need to go a little bit further, more modern, and let our youth enjoy the arts.
I'm here with Joe McDonald. Joe, today you're being recognized for being one of the only people on the reserve to receive a Royal Conservatory of Music certificate. How does that feel, being one of the only people to have one of those?
I think it's great. I think it's a blessing, and I'm very grateful to have it, and I worked hard for it.
Good. You sure did work hard for it. Do you think that us putting on a show like this really helps you out, and you as an artist out, you as a performer out, and you as a person out?
Oh yeah, for sure. I think that this is one of the greatest things to happen, and that we have so much talent on the reserve, and it's great that we're getting it out there, and I'm happy about this. It feels like we're starting something big, and it's going somewhere, and we're gonna find a lot of new talent.
I think it'll go to show and emphasize that our Native youth and our Native communities have a lot of talent that's been overlooked for many generations. With the connection with Native Media Network and Tribal Alliances, they're going to take our youth and put them in front and behind the cameras, which I think is an awesome, awesome adventure. I look forward to seeing some of our youth on screen, behind the cameras, and taking it and running with it. To tell you
think of Enoch Arts and the Fine Arts program?
Actually, it's a good program. I really enjoy it. I like the kids that they are the ones that are focusing more on arts and music. I notice we have a lot of talent in Enoch, so I really like to focus more on the music side of that for arts.
So as a band member going into this brand new partnership, what do you expect from the future?
I expect big things, just bigger and better things for our kids in our future from Enoch. Nobody said it was easy. No one ever said it would be this.
one of the top hip-hop acts of the Enoch Reserve, a true artist. Neil, are you excited for today?
Yeah, I'm excited. I've been looking forward to this well since I got back from the UK, so it should be interesting to see how it goes.
Like, yo, I just want to tell you the truth. If it breaks studio in this studio booth, then I did what I was meant to do. Then I did what I was chosen to do. But all you really want to do is just listen to you. I listen to what my mama said. Oh, we see the truth. Then I did as I walk into the...
I think you could probably make a more native artist more known in the media and actually get to showcase more of our talent as artists. And there's a lot of talented people out there that just don't have a medium to be able to show it. So I think anything promoting hip-hop, native music, anything, it's all good.
Good. Are you, you have the closing portion of the event today. Are you getting pumped up for that?
I am. I'm ready, man. I've been working on it last 3 days nonstop with my friend Jason. We got a good show planned for you guys, so hope you guys like it.
That's just like we all get so frustrated by all this waiting and these pointless conversations. I'm not just hating, it's the truth, I just explained it.
We actually have an LA-based production company housing in Enoch and just a brand new partnership, and actually we're doing an interview for them. It's called the Native Media Network. What do you think about that?
Oh, it's great. I'm glad that you guys are branching out, you know, like taking up the Native community. It's always good. I love seeing the Native community like doing well, so yeah, I think it's great.
Awesome. Well, it's a great thing because this whole phenomenon is just,
yeah, the phenomenon.
It's just bringing such a wide range of different cultures, and like they're helping us breach walls that have never been overcome before, and they're just opening up so many doors, so it's really...
Yeah,
great.
I'd just like to say welcome to the West Edmonton Mall. Thank you for coming to the Solar Fashion Show.
Yeah.
And I'd like to give a special thanks.
And that's why I think Twilight is great. Like, honestly, like as an Aboriginal actor, like we're Aboriginal actors, right? Twilight has opened a lot of doors for us. And as an Aboriginal community, it's opened a lot of doors, right? Like, this is a huge film, right? So it's definitely helping us out.
Give it up to our beautiful models.
And Solar Fashion. Thank you guys very much.
Yeah. Hey, Kelly, how you doing?
Good.
What's happening to you right now?
Chevy's doing my makeup.
What is it? What are you doing your makeup for?
Modeling for the fashion show, Solar Fashion Show.
How do you feel about being asked to model as a part of the Native community?
It feels great to represent my people, to show a different side of us that not everyone's used to seeing. Chevy Rabbit, he's an awesome Native makeup artist that represents our people very well, did an amazing job. We had hair done by Regis Salon upstairs, and it took about 3 women to do my hair. We always want to show that we are beautiful people, we're just like everybody else. They used to tell me I was silly. Till I popped up on the TV. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I always wanted to be a superstar. And knew that singing songs would give me this.
I feel like, seriously, this, I couldn't ask for anything better. I couldn't ask for a better event. I couldn't really be happier with the way that things turned out. I think that the whole world should see Native talent and Native, especially young Native talent, and how good they are. Like, they only have to get better, and it's just really, it's really touching, and I'm so happy that Tribal Alliances and Native Media Network came out to support this, and the leadership from Enoch, and just the whole world. It's in the biggest mall in the world, so we couldn't ask for anything more, and I'm so happy with the event, and I thank each and everybody who was a part of it, and I hope that this is the smallest event we ever produce, so that's how I feel.